G'day, songwriters, musicians, and music lovers. This is Jake from Evolve Songwriting. Welcome back. Today, I have a fantastic album review reaction, and that is Space Island by Broods. I had a different album planned, and then this one just dropped, and I'm a huge Broods fan. So I couldn't wait. I just really want to get stuck into this 10 track. I think the first single, I can't even remember the name of the first single, but I did listen to it once, which was a while back. It's pretty much left my mind though. Apart from that, everything's new. I'm very excited. They did another collaboration with Tuvalu, who featured on their bunch of their songs before. It's a very abstract, unique concept album, at least from the artwork and the visuals, which I've seen snippets of from their social media. So it's been really creative just looking at that. And I have no idea if the music's going to reflect that. I think it's going to be kind of synthy, futuristic. I mean, the word Space Island, that just stimulates all this kind of futuristic, weird, I mean, plus the visuals. I think it's going to be a little bit out there. But Broods, I think their writing is fairly pop. Their last album, Don't Feed the Pop Monster, I think that was gold. That was just a beautiful album. Super well done. Super unique. And I don't know. I feel like Broods, they take really different approaches to each album and give everything a bit of a, like the contrast between the albums is just fairly big for them, I feel like. That's all I know about the album. It's 10 tracks. I'm very excited to get stuck into it. Before we get started, just a reminder, if you want to see more, you can subscribe down below. But let's head into it with the first track. All right, kicking off the album, we have Goodbye World, Hello Space Island. So it seems just like some sort of intro track. And let's have a look here. We have written by Caleb and Georgia from the duo from Broods, Jose Daniel Brenes Mora, Matias Mora, siblings perhaps, Mia Minichiello. Produced by Jose Daniel Brenes Mora and Kyle Berzel and Caleb Knott. Let's give it a go. Goodbye World, Hello Space Island. Yeah, being an intro, it's probably going to be quite ambient. Yeah. Set the mood for the whole record, I think. Georgia worked on the Venus project, which had a lot of this kind of thing. There's the laser beams. It's a space island. So we're getting this kind of nature crossover with laser beam sort of. Oh, okay. Funky. It's real jazzy chord-wise. A lot of it's just in that bass line. Cool. Yeah. Just a little sort of, a little taster, a little. Just heaps of sound design and weird, wacky stuff. Oh, and we're going to lead into the next track, but we're going to pause it. Cool. I love it. A little seamless transition there, but that was Goodbye World, Hello Space Island. Yeah, just an intro to the vibe of the album. Just we had some nature sounds with the laser beams. I think that really what stood out to me is we're sort of entering that crossover. It's like, yeah, we're entering Space Island. So whatever that means, I don't know. Now that I've got those things flowing in my head to ride off to Space Island. Next track. Track two, but I guess this is really sort of the first track. But this is Peace of My Minds, written by AJ, that's a struggle, Bhattacharya, Caleb and Georgia, produced by Stint, Kyle and Caleb. That kind of drum machine feel. Ooh. Got that dissonance. A lot of semitone action. Got that happening. Woo! The melodies are great. But it's super groovy at the same time. I like that bounce, like... That. Cool, so it's still quite poppy. Cool little lyrics there. Look, it's actually quite a simple song. I mean, you've just got this super solid, groovy, drum machine-y groove. Like, that just drives the song forward. High tempo. You've got a few sort of ambient noises that string everything together, keep it glued. And a bass line and a vocals. Like, she's kind of singing fairly monotone through the verses. We're just kind of alternating that sort of semitone area. But we chorus, we sort of extend out a little bit more melodically. Really like the bounce going back and forth in the chorus melodically. That's just a real catchy. That's such an interesting song. Wow. It's very Broods, very on point for them. Their synths are definitely weird. There's a lot of weird noises, little sound effects, a lot of weird modulating in the synths. Some a little funky, you know, we had that, those semitones in the vocal melody and the bass. And then I think in the chorus we start here. We play the chorus one more time. I think the chords in the chorus are very interesting. This one. That's really cool, right? So we start on a G, which is not the tonic here. I think B flat, back to the G. But then we go up to B natural and some sort of diminished, I think, which is really, really cool. It's an interesting chord progression. Never really heard that before. The harmonic elements in the song, I feel like, are secondary here to the sort of thick, wide vocals, definitely very wide, a lot of layers, and the groove in the bass take real center stage, I think, which is definitely what you want for a song with such a high tempo. Looks like that may have been the lead single. Yeah. So this is probably the one I heard. I actually forgot all of that song because that has the highest plays here. Anyways, moving on, track number 3. Next up, we have track 3, Heartbreak, which is written by AJ again, Caleb in Georgia, produced by Stint, Carl, and Caleb. So we'll see where we go. This is Heartbreak. Okay, here's some weird synths. That's cool. There's bass lines again. Yeah, and the super programmed drums. Like, the drums so far have just been very... intentionally, you know, it doesn't have much of a live feel to the drums. His bass lines are kind of wild. And then she's singing again, quiet, monotone. Love it. Love the halftime. Whoa. That's Georgia in a nutshell, those vocal harmonies. It's quite gentle on the ears. Another pickup in the chorus. There you are. We extend the subdivision a little more too. Yeah. Her vocalizations are great. So she uses that a lot. Or both of them. I mean, they both sort of write this together, I feel. After that line, it's like sometimes you don't need lyrics, you know, and you just need a nice little haunting melody. And you just get these laser beams. Everything's very wet with reverb too. Same with the previous track. Just really sitting around that. Just sort of low end of the scale until we hit there. And we start hitting these, the high, the fifth. Oh, there's synths, man. That's Caleb's work for sure, man. Really great drum program. They actually are now feeling a little bit more live. A bit more ghost notes. Yeah, we have that open hat that's just giving us a really strong offbeat. Fantastic. Well, that's a tune. I'll be listening to that a few times. Songwriting wise, you could write a lot of this kind of stuff if you just maybe have some sort of drum machine. Plug in a groove, get a tempo sorted, and then think of a top line over the top. If I was writing a song like this, it would just be chucking that groove on, and then I would have, you know, tried to come up with that hook. And just sort of jamming that over the top. Good use of contrast in the subdivision. So we see in the chorus, da, da, a little bit of a longer note, and then this sort of counter line, da, 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 and we switch back between subdivisions there. And then pitch wise, which I just mentioned, you know, in the verse, again, we're still sitting. Oops, sorry. We sort of sit around that, the first 4 degrees of the scale, or three even, in the verses before we pick up and head to the fifth and the fourth up. In the chorus, the layering, man. I mean, Georgia Knot is just the queen of those soft, gentle harmonies. I don't know how to describe the sound of her voice and when she does these stacks. It's so great, and it works really well with this sort of electronic vibe. This song feel like it could have been on Conscious, on the album Conscious, but it's just like it's a little more sweet and a little more. It's less edgy. It's less dark. Cool. Love that track. Absolutely love that track. Let's hit up number 4. Cool. Track 4 is Distance and Drugs. Great title. We have written by Caleb Georgia, Kyle Berzel, and Mitchell. Produced by Kyle Berzel and Caleb Knott. Let's go. Ooh. Super creative guitar tone. Drum machine-y, percussion, weird synth sounds. A lot of the same elements across all these songs. Just put together in different ways, different chords, different grooves. Notice the velocities in the drum program. That's very important there. It already gets this kind of swelling going. The hats and the snare. You know, just playing with the velocities there. Make sure to write your velocities, guys. Cool. Fast-paced vocal. So we have repeating rhythmic motifs. And then we change it up there in the last line to give us a transition. We had this. A lot of the same rhythms, but then we just hit the triplet ending there. Interesting. Oh, there it is. That snare pattern. Drums feel a little delayed as well. The synth just really washes over you. We're here. A lot of that feel in the vocal. So much weird production choices. Like, good weird. because it fits the whole vibe. It's so interesting. We have here that we have the halftime, and then we went to this weird offbeat snare in the chorus. That's so weird. But this drum pattern. Oh man. There's not a lot of harmonic movement here. We sit on that for ages. And then. So very long distances between the chord changes. If you do that, you definitely have to have a strong groove because we have to sort of have some forward motion, which chords can generally provide. You know, the typical sort of one every bar or two bars. But we're sitting on the chords a long time and you need a good present groove to really carry through that. And there's just like that hint of jazziness there as well. And the synth voicings. And sort of her voice maybe adding to some of those stacks too. we have a more simple bass line going on in this track compared to the other two, but the bass is a lot bigger, like just sonically. So we can really hear that pump and the sidechain going on in the bass and the kick. But here we're sitting and then we change chords. Oh, we changed there. And we pull out. Dude, like, very interesting. That really shaped the album. That's what I was expecting when I see these kind of visuals from their video clips, the album art. That song is a representation of that. But yeah, I mean, it's the same thing. It's just you got this kind of very drum machine-y. It has a fairly wide pitch range still, but it's really over the course of the whole song. Still haven't really seen a song here where we get a sort of wildly up and down melody for a hook or something. It's super groove centric. I think towards more the electronic program side, it doesn't quite feel too human. This one had a lot of the drums weren't quantized completely. Maybe like pulled late a little bit. But yeah, interesting. Next one I'm super excited for because we have the collab. Let's dive into it. Cool. This is the moment I've been waiting for. We have I Keep, performed by Broods, featuring Tuvalu, written by Caleb George, Carl, Madeline Eliasson, and Tuvalu, produced by Carl, Caleb, and Madeline. Their last collab that I remember hearing was Freak of Nature from Conscious, and it was a masterpiece. I'm so excited for this track. Let's go. Another similar intro to the last song. Very syncopated vocal top line. Same thing with the groove. More semitones. Simple. Add the harmony. It's given us that. Like A6 chord, yeah. Tops part. The verses here are a little more singer-songwriter-y. It's same things that shows up in every song. Hard to pull off. So you have a little bit more of a wild verse, syncopation, crazy bouncy sort of boom, gut, dum, gut, dum, gut, dum, gut. There's a lot of rhythmic anomalies going on in the verses, but then, you know, we take a break from that and we get just a simple, I keep boom, boom, one, two, three, four, just quarter notes, da, da, simple melody, which is just our semitone there again, provides that real steadiness every now and then. But yeah, what I was going to mention before is that it's really cool how some of these other instruments, like the synths in this case, the plucky guitar sounding thing that we hear in the intro, we're in A, but you hear these, that F sharp in there, which provides the sixth, and it gives it that sort of, that's where that sort of slight jazziness comes from. Great way to sort of add texture. Call and response. Lots of stacking on the vocal. Quite lengthy harmonic movement here. Staying on the same chord for a while. Just a lot of unique production design and elements. It's got like almost an EDM feel with just how much they're just sitting on a lot of grooves. A section, B section, right? A section, I keep. He always got those little melodies in the transitions there. B section. But it's still straight rhythms, right? Just a different subdivision. Yeah. These songs have great energy to them. Yeah, cool. Excellent. Not as much of a feature for Tuvalu. Like, I don't know. I guess I was really attached to the sort of more emotional style that they did with Freak of Nature and just the big vocals from Georgia, which we haven't seen yet. Very similar to the other tracks. It's just groove-centric, some interesting lush synth sounds and extensions of the chords, a lot of layered vocals, big harmony stacks. But, you know, she keeps them very airy, so they're not super in your face. They're just adding to that texture. It's like indie dance music. They've just put a lot more focus on doing maybe different things or unique things and adding different chord voicings or whatever, textures, sound design into the production. More so here. I think Caleb is doing a lot more of the production because I know in the earlier stuff they got help from Joel Little, who is definitely more of a traditional pop, dark pop, electronic pop sort of producer. So yeah, we'll keep going. That's halfway. Next is Like a Woman, which just seems like it's a bit more popular than the other tracks. We've got a few more plays. Maybe it was released as a single. I don't know. But let's get into it. Track 6, Like a Woman. This is written by Caleb and Georgia. Kyle Berzel, Noah Berrison, produced by Caleb, Kyle, Noah. Georgia had a whole project about womanhood on the Venus Project. Sure, we get a lot of her influence here. Get that, like, phaser. The tones, man. Okay, here we go. This is the stuff I love. Yeah, this is super Georgia. But I never felt like a woman to you. Quick pause. Like, this is what I love about her. We have a bit more of a singer-songwriter thing going on now, which is a great break for the middle of the album. This is an opportunity now to get away from the groove and focus on the lyrics, which have been really awesome. Like a woman to you. So I'm hoping that her vocal really stays front center lyrically. Everything just supporting that. Yeah. Like a woman to you. I've come a long, long way with the things that you gave me. Ooh. Okay, a little bit of a groove. But yeah, it's a lot more subtle, right? Don't really have a snare. Mmm. Wow. Okay, I didn't expect it to go here, but I love that it did. The bass! That's got to be live drums. Oh, that's big. Still, so many interesting textures. And then we get shocked out of it. Silence. I kind of wish it was longer. It all happened so fast. That was a really unique song. I love it. Absolutely love it. I just think because of how big it gets, it could have maybe gone with a few more, just a bit longer to build that up and just maybe one more stage. But that's just peak Georgia vocal arrangement. Still a lot of those weird synth sounds and the weird textures, but we had definitely more of a live drum feel. There wasn't much lyrics to it. A lot of it was just like a woman to you, which I think repeating that so many times just keeps it focused, and it's like that is the message here. I mean, this is super creative. Structurally, yeah. Okay, here's the lyric. We had the one verse. Oh, I know you cared for me like your own baby, draped in pink with a drawer full of blue. I felt so loved like a sweet little lady, but I never felt like a woman to you. I mean, that, wow. And then hook is just like a woman to you, like a woman to you. And then we only have one more verse. I've come a long way with the things that you gave me. I appreciate everything you would do. And I felt so safe in the bubble you made me, but I never felt like a woman to you. Like a woman to you, like a woman to you. So only two verses and a single line, like a woman to you, but it hits. Yeah, reading those lyrics now, you can clearly see it's sort of a commentary on perhaps, gender conformity. I felt so safe in the bubble you made me, and we have the drapes in pink and a drawer full of blue. So, but it just has that one key line, like a woman to you, and that just speaks a lot. And I think repeating that so many times is great. So super minimal on the lyrics. Yeah, that was a great climax. I'm very keen to keep going. Let's hit the next track. Cool, next track is Gaslight. And this one, just written by George Anot and Noah Berrison, produced by Noah Berrison. So Caleb is not appearing at all on this track. Another lo-fi kind of plucky guitar intro. I like the, it's a pretty typical lyrical structure. You had sort of A, B, A, C, and we also had the chord change in the C section as well, which was a really interesting chord. It went to the, wait till it comes back around. E major. That one. It's a great chord. Very rich backing. There it is again. Great way to get back to the tonic. You don't see that chord progression too often. It's just contrast. A lot of great guitar tones happening and guitar parts in the background, but all the contrast here is just overall as a feel. We have this sort of picking with the da 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 da. The lines are a bit more spaced out, shorter syllables, and then we move into, I guess, this chorus where everything's more drawn out. We have a lot more layers. It just feels bigger and it feels wider. It feels more lush. So it's just really playing with the contrast here. Baby, A lot of sadder, more melancholy chords, sticking on the 6 minor for a long time. And then we're back to E again. Excellent. Yeah, pretty simple song. A lot of like, all these weird vibrato-y, and this time it was guitar rather than on the synths. So it's still fairly cohesive with that. But yeah, complete lack of a groove. That's the first song where we haven't really had a groove at all. Played a lot with the contrast in the vocal line, going between this sort of intimately spaced and then really expanding that atmosphere out with longer subdivisions through the chorus. Cool. Moving on, we have the next track. Let's have a listen. This one is Days Are Passing, written by Caleb Georgia and Noah Barrison, produced by Noah Barrison and Caleb. Caleb's back in. Let's go. Straight out the gate. Jazzy, seventh chords. Great sound design, synth as usual. Ooh, that's a nice little, I guess, call and response. A little taste of the groove there. Let's go. More laser beam sounds. Oh. Okay. Was not expecting that. Huge bass drop. Dum, dum, dum. Just sticking with that seventh chord progression. Nice little harmonic timing at the end there, right? We have like, let's have a listen again. Chord, chord, chord. Yeah, 2 beats per chord rather than 4 beats, which it is now. Such a cozy tune. Compared to the earlier tracks, is the drums sound a lot more alive. It's got almost like a cajon sound in that snare. It feels a bit lighter. Yeah, I'd say lyrically and top line wise on the vocal, it's not really a feature at all. Like it's just parts. I don't really feel, it's not really like much of a song with like a story to it. It's just cool, catchy melodic ideas thrown over cool, catchy rhythmic ideas. It's interesting. I guess they did a little bit of it in the previous album. But I will say I do miss the heavy pop tunes. Like we had, was it Peach on the last album? I really liked Dust and pretty much everything on Conscious. Big shift in style here. But it is in a lot more alignment with the Venus project that George did. Just like, that's what I mean, right? Like, that lyrically it could be anything as long as you have the it's like just these small 2 or 3 note melodies that just work in with the groove. It's so good though that artists now are feeling comfortable putting out just really creative, unique, original stuff. It's just a jam. It's just a jam track, man. Yeah. Very cruisy. I mean, funky. It was quite funky. There's been a little bit of a funkiness to this album. Yeah, it's definitely nothing that I was, I didn't know what to expect, but compared to older broods where we had very structured songs, we had very pop driven and, you know, clear hooks, clear verses, singer songwriter style verses. This is very different. Next one's Alien, so maybe we can get real weird. Second to last track, Alien, we have. Written by Georgia and Noah, produced by Noah. Again, Caleb not appearing on this track, which is interesting because I think Caleb was the source of a lot of these weird synth sound design noises and modulating things, which I would expect from a track called Alien. So who knows what we'll get. Let's go. Interesting. Where'd you come from again? It's an odd time signature. Are you no. Oh, such interesting rhythms. It's really hard to follow, like, groove wise. I think it is still 4-4, but there's just so many offbeats and syncopated things going on. You can tell that this is, yeah, this Noah dude, I'm guessing he's the guitarist on this and Gaslight. Just from the tones and the way he plays. Feel just like you, I'm an alien too. Great line. Simple. Again, very cruisy. We've really taken a dip in energy since the beginning of the album. And so you're never really like grounded harmonically. So same here. You just come from here to there and then back. So it doesn't feel resolved really ever. I think there's a couple more chord changes in there, but it gives you that sort of unsteadiness in the harmony. Yeah, interesting choice. I would have thought Alien, being the title, had a lot more to do with some more wacky things and the whole Space Island theme. The sort of punchline there, which was, what was it again? I said it before. Just like you are, I'm an alien too or something. And yeah, it's really a really great line. You can build a whole song off that line. But great guitar work. But credit to Noah. Yeah, interesting album. Totally not expected from Broods. Let's hit the last track, shall we? Final track on the album, If You Fall In Love. We got Leroy Clampett, who hasn't appeared yet. Caleb Knott, Georgia Knott as the writers, and produced by Leroy and Caleb. Final track. Where do we finish this journey? Yeah, Caleb's back. Laser beams. It's got that like old TV show like Star Trek sort of soundtrack style. Yeah, Shakers. Getting a little tropical with it. Beautiful chord still. Super. Happy, very major sound. Cool. This is a bit more traditional structure. Hard to describe. This is something that Bruce does really well. That whispery, airy vocal. This is definitely what I'm more used to from them. Except for that light drum beat. But it's good. I mean, this whole album had a lighter feel to it. Just typical ABAB patterns. We're down to these. Yeah, so we didn't have the C line there to transition into the pre-chorus, but we had a little pickup into the pre-chorus and we changed rhythmically a lot. We get that rhythmic. Just using that over and over again. Really, really effective songwriting when you do that. And now we're back. Drawn out, everything long. Oh, Yeah. Oh, yeah. So we see, I was just playing that, right? So the bringing that vocal motif into the guitar. It's nice. Cool. Now we're just vibing out with the drums and the sound effects. So it's possible to build a song just over that one melody, right? If you can find the right groove for it. Love the tremolo at the end. And that's the album. I really like what this is. I feel like Broods as a whole, but mainly Georgia with her vocals, does this really well. It's like she makes it so you're listening to it. And a lot of the time, for me at least, it feels like it's not even lyrics or words. If like she can blend her voice in so well with the song that you can just really get carried away in the melodies and the airiness and the tone of her voice without really paying attention to the lyrics if you don't want to. It's this really weird phenomenon that I only really get it from her, and her voice really melts into the music that they make. You know, a lot of songs you can really separate. Okay, this is the backing and the singer's singing over that, both mix-wise and just what we hear as listeners. But Broods, a lot of the time, I just feel like it's so hard to separate her vocal from their whole production, especially in that song. Anyway, that was the last track. Let's just do a quick summary of the album. And there we have it. That was Space Island by Broods. Very interesting album. Something has been definitely evolving, really experimenting with originality. I felt that in their last album, and even Conscious. I've always felt like Broods have done their own thing really well. But yeah, this time they've really explored a super unique niche, something that I wasn't expecting from them. The first sort of half of the album was super groove orientated. There was a lot of just holding a groove and very minimal on the lyrics. But yeah, structure-wise and genre-wise, this is something completely different. And I'll have to say, I do want to give that another listen. It's probably not my favorite Broods album. I would put Conscious up the top. I mean, I think that was an absolute world-class dark pop album. This one, maybe just being a sort of more niche genre, won't get the kind of attention that the other albums got. So yeah, awesome stuff from the duo. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed that and took some tips from that. That's some really interesting songwriting going on there. I would say as a producer, there's a lot to tackle there. Something that I didn't really get into, but wow, some of the sound design choices there were epic. And that was just a lot of sounds like Caleb having fun with synths. Yeah, if you enjoy that, again, you can subscribe down below. If you have any recommendations on what albums I should listen to, I'm thinking next is going to be Dominion by Skillet. That dropped fairly recently. But yes, thank you very much for watching. This has been Jake from Evolve Songwriting. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.